Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to paint watercolor strawberries. Now I had the request to paint watercolor strawberries and my first thought was to use masking fluid. And then I also thought, well, I have bleed proof white, but then I thought if you don't have either of those, I should also show you how to do it without anything except just your watercolor. And so today I'm going to show you three different ways depending on the materials that you have on hand to paint beautiful watercolor strawberries. So let's get started. The reason I'm using different materials to show you how to paint these watercolor strawberries is because of the seeds of the strawberry. And so I'm sketching out a basic strawberry shape, which really can be anything, but I stuck to a triangular shape with curved edges, some little spiky leaves at the top, and then I did a little extra baby strawberry to the side that's kind of growing. But for this example, I'm using masking fluid to mask off where the seeds are. But because the little seeds on the strawberry are yellow, I'm painting it yellow first. So I'm sketching out where I want the seeds, and so I'm just doing simple little lines for the seeds and then painting over it within my outline sketch this bright yellow color that I want my seeds to be. Masking fluid acts as a protectant against paint. So once it's completely dried, I can paint over it with red and the yellow color will stay the same. Now I'm using the little lines as a guide because I don't want the lines to show up once the masking fluid is off. So I'm painting the masking fluid right next to the lines. And then once it's completely dry, then I get to go in with this beautiful red color for the strawberries right over the top. Also, for reference, you'll notice that as we progress along this method, you'll see the next method being worked on to the right, and that's because as I let everything dry, I filmed and worked on the other methods next to it. So just for reference, I will go over all of those options. And then to note here, I did do a little bit of green to show that this is a work in progress strawberry, and so I just love how that added to the contrast for that little strawberry. And then while the paint is still wet, I'm going through and adding a darker pigment of red around the masking fluid seeds. For the greenery, it's all pretty much the same on each strawberry. I did a mid-tone green and kept my strokes really light, pretty much just following loosely the sketch that I did before. And again, keep your strokes light, keep your strokes thin. You can always go back and add more pressure to some of those areas. Now I'm going through and adding a darker pigment of red as a shadow around each of these seeds. And you're going to want to make sure that the base color of red is totally dry so that this doesn't become a blended situation. You really want this line of shadow to stand out because it makes the seeds pop. And as a little side note, I did green around the green areas of the strawberry. Now, once everything is totally dry, has to be totally dry, you can remove the masking fluid for your little seeds. I'm adding a dark golden color to each of the seeds as well on the side that is closer to the shadow. And this just adds more depth, more contrast, more interest, and really helps the seeds not look so stark, bright yellow. One of the things that can be frustrating with masking fluid is that the lines that it creates, the lines that it protects, can be really uneven. And so these seeds are a little bit wonky, which is totally fine. I really actually love that. But I'm going through with some light red and kind of smoothing out some of the wonkier, jagged edges. I also felt like I needed to add more contrast from the left side of the strawberry, which is the more shadowed, dark side of the strawberry, compared to the right side of the strawberry, which has lighter features. So I very carefully went around all of the seeds on the left side of the strawberry, adding that darker pigment of red to increase the contrast. Now to finish this strawberry, we're adding a dark green pigment to the leaves and the stem. And again, this is not specific to the masking fluid method. I'm going to be doing this on all of the strawberries, but remember to keep your strokes light and thin and to keep it minimal because the dark green acts as a shadow and a contrast. And so you don't want to overwhelm the greenery with it. So now we are moving on to method number two, which is using bleed proof white or some type of white paint or white gel pen to create the marks of our seeds. So I have the almost exact same sketch for this strawberry, and because I don't have to worry about where the seeds are, I just go straight to painting the red of the strawberry. With this strawberry, I'm keeping the shadows on the left side and the lightness on the right. And the way to do that is to paint the entire thing one base light red color, and then to add a darker red pigment on the side you want shadow. And then you can lift away some pigment on the lighter sides that you need to keep bright. And again, I'm adding just that touch of green on the little baby strawberry. And I'm speeding through this part. You've already seen it before. Keep it light and loose. Midtones, all that jazz. So we are using Dr. PH Martin's Bleed Proof White to create the little seeds. But again, you can use any type of paint, opaque watercolor or gel pens for this method. And this is pretty much, you know, the quote unquote cheating method, because you're just painting on what you kind of took away, that white paper. And because I don't have yellow paint, I'm going through and adding a really quick light wash of yellow to my white seeds, and then going through and taking some of it away. Because once I painted on the yellow and I looked at the whole thing, I thought, wow, I put way too many seeds on here. I got really carried away when I painted them on myself. The great thing about using this method is I just took my red watercolor and kind of erased some of the ones I didn't like. And I thought it looked really good in the end. So there you go. There's a way to do it. It's probably easier to not be like me and just paint the right amount of seeds that looks good to you. But you know, you can do it this way if you want to. And then I am going through and adding some darker pigment to again increase the contrast of our shadow on the left side of the strawberry. Once that base color of red has dried, I can go in with an even darker color pigment of red and add the shadows on that left side of the seeds. I also thought my little baby strawberry was too light on the red side, and so I added some contrast there. And again, here comes the dark green contrast for the greenery. Keep it light. Keep it simple, keep it really loose and organic. And now we move on to our third and final method, which is nothing. It's just all watercolor and skill. So I did the same basic sketch, but for the sketch for the seeds, I did specifically long oval seed shapes. And then I very meticulously went through with my watercolor and I pretty much traced around each of these seed shapes. So this takes a long time, and it also is kind of stressful because you don't want any hard lines to form while you're painting one area meticulously and then another area dries. And so you have to work rather quickly so that you don't get those hard lines. And you'll see that even with my best efforts, it's still a little blotchy. So keep in mind that with this method, it's just harder to get that smooth, even finish that you can get when you use masking fluid or when you don't care and you have to paint over it with the bleed-proof white. And again, more greenery. We're gonna skip through that a little bit. And you can tell me in the comments if you're mad at me about this, if you wanted me to show every single detail in real time, let me know. Now I'm adding the yellow to the entire strawberry, but mostly to my blocked out seed areas. And this is similar to when I painted over the bleed proof white. And then I'm also going through and adding the shadows on the left side around the seeds. And I'm adding more contrast to the left side of the strawberries. And pretty much doing from this point the same thing that I was doing on the other methods, because really the methods are related to how the seeds are applied and how you make it look like a strawberry with those seeds. And that is it. Three different ways to paint watercolor strawberries depending on what materials you have at home and also depending on what you like best and how much effort you want to put into it. So let me know in the comments below which one you like best and which one you are going to try out. I will see you guys next time. Bye.